Thank you. The first time I even heard of Borgström was through a good family friend who is very, very passionate about Borgström and his music. He gave me a big pile of his music, which I did leave at home for a little bit, and it did collect a little bit of dust. But when I did open it up, I saw there was a violin concerto lying there. I was not expecting that at all, and I just started to play a little bit on it, and the piece was speaking to me immediately. There was something about it, there was the quality of it, the beauty, that really was so intriguing. He was studying in Leipzig, and he was in Berlin, where he met Busoni, amongst others. And he had this philosophy of ways of composing, how he wanted music to sound. He clearly loved the romantic periods. I think especially second movement, you can just hear this extremely romantic opera, and it is an aria basically. It's a bit like Wagner, it's so many references. You can hear a few seconds and then you think, oh, could it be? And then no, it's not, but the resemblance is definitely there. But at the same time, he really had managed to make this very Nordic sounding, very Norwegian. What triggers the Norwegian feeling, I think, is a little mix of kind of folk music harmonies, meaning from Hardanger fiddle. I often find some resemblance to fjords and mountains, and especially in this area where I'm from, we have Jotunheimen, which is the most beautiful mountain chain. And just hearing this music, it triggers this mental picture. It's very lyrical, very simplistic melodies that just goes directly into your heart. Borgström was really unfortunate that he was just forgotten. He was just a little bit late by the time he was composing his big symphony and the lyrical poems. People were already looking into different directions and new impulses. It's a massive privilege to be able to show this piece to the world and to people, because it's so linked also to my identity of being Norwegian and coming from this kind of place, the countryside, and have something that resonates so much with this. Also at the same time that it is actually a really, really good piece. It's not just a Norwegian piece that no one plays, but now is maybe the time to finally bring it back and give it the attention it deserves.